The hospital had given us this suite, which was obviously a grieving suite. It had a delivery room in it, and off that it had a double bedroom. And it also had a little room off the delivery suite, which was where Jude was kept in a cold room.
I went through to get Jude into this room and couldn't find him. And sort of like turned out the corner of my eye, I saw this fridge. Just a normal fridge like you would have in your house. And when I opened the fridge, Jude was in the fridge, and my heart sank at that point. And I just thought, can things get any worse? I took Jude home, much to the annoyance of the hospital at the time, but I took him home, and we spent the last couple of days that we had with Jude in his nursery. He's seen his nursery. We had him at home for a couple of days before the funeral. Yeah, that's still very, very vivid in my mind, and it probably will be to the day I die. Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better.
Remember to let her under your skin. People that are so vibrant and so lovely, and then you find out what actually has gone on in their lives, and it pulls the heartstrings. And when you find out a bit more about stillbirth and neonatal death, and that it happens frequently, 17 kids a day, you know, how can you not want to be involved? Just to raise as much awareness as possible, because if we can impact a future family, then that's a win-win.
Largely, just as a parent, knowing the kind of pressures that parents go through, coming up to that very crucial time just before birth, and more importantly, just after birth. So anything that I could do to help out, I thought, yeah, I would. The foundation was set up primarily to raise funds and awareness for stillborn children and for families having to deal with it.
It's something very dear to my heart because I've had a similar situation with a younger brother who 15 minutes after he was born, unfortunately he died.
The Jude Brady Foundation came about because of a fundraising day we had after Jude died. I felt that I had to do something to help me come to terms with Jude's death. So got a few friends together and we had a golf day. And at that golf day, which was a bit spur of the moment, we raised £6,000. And we enjoyed it that much that we thought, let's do it again the following year.
I've seen its growth, not only since my involvement, but through other people that have come together to make this a professional setup now. It's really getting bigger and we can actually see where we're going, which is great. And we've quadrupled funds that we got years ago. We're already sort of doubled and tripled every year, which is great.
Hopefully it can be massive. Every year we have raised the bar in with money that we have raised for the charity. So who's to say, hopefully we can raise it beyond all belief.
As a parent, I think that, you know, having a child stillborn would be nothing worse. And maybe the only thing worse would be to not have the support around you to help you deal with that. And I've learned in life, generally speaking, that quite often we're resilient to the initial facts, but it's the bit afterwards that makes all the difference. And I think if you've got a network of people around you, whether it be information, in some cases support might be financial, sometimes it might just be emotional support, that it can make a huge, huge difference. And even though a lot of the money that we raise eventually will go into research and to help with stuff like that, some of it will be to do with general support. And, you know, it does mean an awful lot to me to be able to do that for parents up and down the UK.
In 5 or 10 years' time, I'd like to think that our charity will be in a position to make a difference to not just one or two people's lives a year, maybe three or four, but hundreds of people's lives a year. You know, we want to raise the profile of stillbirth. It's still a very huge priority for me. People need to know that there's 6,500 babies dying every year in this country. And, you know, the more people that get on board and start supporting us and taking this message to the government and all the rest of it, then maybe there's a chance that something will happen. I would love in Jude's sort of memory, his legacy, to have actually made a difference.